So guys, being that I used to work in a pet store, people often ask me, what is the reptile that I recommend most for little children? Now, all reptiles, in my opinion, make great pets, but for little kids, usually you want to go with stuff that's easy to handle, that's not too aggressive, that has the least chance of biting the children as possible, because little kids will freak out if they have what looks to be a little dinosaur biting down on them. So ideally we want something that is easy to handle, easy to take care of, something that stays pretty small. And I'm going to show you guys three options right now, and I want to know what you guys think is the best pet for children. And then I'll tell you what I think personally is the absolute best, not just reptile pet for children, but the absolute best choice of a pet to get for a child. So we have option A over here, a crested gecko. These guys are pretty easy to handle, at least when they're adults. They could be very jumpy though, especially when young. And a big selling point of these guys is that they don't need to eat crickets as much as the leopard gecko, which is going to be one of the other options. So people really like these guys, especially because of the fact that they don't need very much heat. They could live pretty well between 69 degrees all the way to 83 degrees about. But ideally, you want to keep them at about 80. So these guys are really easy to take care of. A couple things that I don't like about these guys is that they tend to crap all over the windows and it's a little bit hard to clean up. So unless you trust your child with a razor blade, you're often going to have to clean the glass for the child. Option B will be the leopard gecko. These guys are extremely easy to handle. Unlike crested geckos, they're not nearly as likely to jump. They'll only really do that when they're young, and even then, they don't jump very far. And they're quite slow, easy to catch in case they do fall on the ground. They're always pretty friendly. I mean, every now and again, you'll catch an aggressive animal, but that could happen with anything, dogs, cats, birds, whatever. But you could see all really easy to pick up. They come in a bunch of different colors, as do the crested geckos. These are probably the easiest lizard to take care of, just because these guys they store a lot of fat and water in their tails. So let's say you're the type of family that goes on vacation often. These guys are something you could actually leave be for a week, even more, if I'm honest with you, as long as they have some fresh water and they have a human hide. Because these animals, they do come from the desert, but what people fail to realize is that they hide during the day in between rock crevices where it is humid. Now, the crested gecko is going to need a lot more humidity than these guys, and usually, if you create a microclimate in this type of lay box I have here, but this, if you had just one leopard gecko, this would be like half the size, and it would have some humid potting soil inside, and you'd keep that on the hot side. Now, that being said, these guys do require a heat pad at least, I would say. If you live in a very cold place, may even need a heat lamp. And if we're talking about the investment, all the animals I'm going to show you cost about the same when you add everything together. They're all going to be pretty much $200, I would say, for all the equipment and the caging and all that. They're all within pretty much the same price range. But leopard geckos are really easy to handle. Now, the one thing that people don't like about leopard geckos is that they need to eat live insects. There are very, very few leopard geckos that'll actually eat prey that's already been killed. So usually that involves the parent having to come to a pet store, buy the crickets or the mealworms or whatever. And it's also a little bit more complicated than that, because if you want your leopard geckos to be in good health, you also have to feed the feeder insects that you feed to your geckos. And this is true with all lizards. Whatever lizards that are going to be insectivores, they need to make sure that their insects are very high in different kind of micronutrients and things like that. Usually you'll just have to buy a gut load formula to feed them. It's not that complicated, but it is a little bit extra work. So that's it for leopard geckos, option B. Now this is option C, a corn snake. This particular animal is a blood red, an amber blood red, I believe.
I'm not too familiar with the corn snake morphs, but yeah, corn snakes, and some people that are going to be watching this video are going to be surprised, but corn snakes in option C is actually what I think is the absolute best animal to get for a child. Now, let me explain why. Basically, snakes are very easy to handle, as they don't have legs, as you could see. So it's very hard for them to get away from somebody who's handling them. I mean, you could drop one, yes, but corn snakes aren't too quick, and snakes in general aren't gonna be too quick. The other reason why snakes are very, very popular and why I think they're the absolute best pets for children is they only need to eat once a week. And the reason why I think corn snakes are really great pets as compared to other snakes is basically I've had hundreds of corn snakes pass through my hands, and I've sold hundreds of corn snakes. I've yet to see a corn snake that won't eat frozen thawed. So snakes do not actually have to eat live rodents, they could eat frozen rodents. Now this is advantageous because you could simply go to a pet store and buy up to 6 months worth of rodents to feed for your snake, and you don't have to go out every week to buy crickets as you would for lizards. So that is one of the big advantages. The other advantage is most snakes don't have very fast metabolisms, and they're only gonna go to the bathroom maybe once or twice a week. So because of this, it's very, very easy to manage cleaning. Again, the reason why I think this is the best animal just in general for children is because the parent with this animal actually doesn't have to do anything. It's so simple for the child to just remove the waste in the corner, and to feed the snake is really easy also and kind of cool. And they don't get very big. That's the other thing, because I think all snakes in general are very awesome pets to own just because they don't require much care. But again, corn snake will win every time when compared to the rest of the snakes, just because they're very, very rarely aggressive. Sometimes only when they're little, and even then when they're small, they have teeth, but if they do snap you, it feels basically like Velcro going off your skin. When they're babies, they can't even make you bleed, basically, if they bite you. Which again is super, super rare that they do. And of course, the other reason is that they stay small. And some people, when they hear that the animal will get 4 feet long, they don't think that's small, but honestly, for a snake, it is small. This guy is about 3 years old, he's a male, he's about 3 feet long, and you could see he's only about this thick. So, actually very small snake. And you could see, really easy to handle. I can handle him just basically with one hand, but you could see they don't move too fast either. That's a big advantage with the corn snake also, is the movement of the animal. It's funner to handle than, let's say, a ball python that won't really move in your hand, but it's also more relaxed than, let's say, a milk snake, which would be darting off in every direction possible, basically. So, I mean, when we're talking about the corn snakes and, like, the perks of keeping one of these animals versus the cons, there's hardly any cons. I mean, if you're squeamish about feeding rodents, obviously that's one of the cons. And the other con, I guess, is if you're a child and you want to buy one of these animals, sometimes it will really take a lot of convincing to let your parent allow you to get a snake. But that's basically why I made this little video, is so that I could show parents that snakes are actually really good animals, and they require hardly any care. As we were saying before with leopard gecko, that you could leave for a week and not have to feed the animal because it stores fat reserves and water reserves in its tail. It's basically the same thing with this animal here. I mean, a corn snake should eat once a week, but honestly, if it goes 2 weeks sometimes, it's fine. And as long as you give it a nice big water bowl, everything should be okay. Another small disadvantage with the corn snake is that its metabolism is quite fast compared to boas and pythons. But then again, boas and pythons get very big. Anyways, hope you guys liked this little video, and if you guys have children, hopefully you'll get them one of these beauties. Really, really like corn snakes. Snakes make awesome pets.